It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1555, recorded Wednesday, January 27th, 2016. Princess Meowa. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we have a way to make sure your children are safe, a ball that you can hack, and some things to put in your stocking. Although Christmas is already over. All next on the Giz Wiz!
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
a nerd pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now! And we are here with the maestro of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing, Dickie?
Yeah, I'm good, sir. And you?
Doing good. Doing really good. We are filming a day early.
Yes.
Because I am leaving to go to...
Actually, we're not filming at all. We are... What do you call it these
recording?
Days? We're magnetizing.
Yeah.
We're digitizing.
Random access memorying.
It's so funny because there's no like new word. I always do the
same
thing.
We're live to disk.
Yes, when I send stuff over to ABC, I say Dick stuff for pre-tape. We haven't taped in.
There's no tape involved.
There's no tape. So now I just say for pre-record.
Right.
Oh, so we're pre-recording.
Pre-recording. There we are. We are pre-recording this episode. Because I'll be heading down to San Antonio for PAX again. Looking forward to it.
And remind us what PAX is.
PAX is the
Penny Arcade
Expo.
Expo.
And there's not a lot of conventions that have video game developers and video game fans. E3 is a great convention, but that's for industry. So PAX has that market kind of corner, and they have three throughout the year in different locations. One south in San Antonio, one east in Boston, and one that they call Prime, which is in Seattle. So they have kind of a triangle of the country there. And I'm going to do the south one in San Antonio. So,
oh, okay. And they're very popular, right?
They are. They are very popular. And this PAX is actually exciting. This is the first time that they are reaching out and trying to record themselves some of the moments of PAX and put it up on their YouTube channel, and I'm going to be the host of that.
Oh, great!
I'm very excited. So for 2 days, I'll be working with the PAX folks and trying to get you guys as much content from the show floor that'll go up on their YouTube channel, the Reeb Pop YouTube channel, and it'll be on their live stream, twitch.tv/PAX. And I'm really looking forward to that. It seems like a perfect fit. I like video games. I like hosting stuff. They needed a host. I'm very excited. So
perfect, perfect.
Have I packed for PAX? I have not. Winter's scrap. So
well, in the interim since last time, we had 27 inches of snow.
I know. You guys, you got so much snow. You had a photo of your boat that I got. I saw. It's covered.
You know what? It was great because I ended up, there's a worry with snow weighing the boat down too much. But it was hard to know how much snow was getting in the boat because it was accompanied by 50-mile-an-hour winds. So I have a drop cam in the front of my boat from that faces the bow, and I could see there was no snow on the dock. As a matter of fact, someone emailed me and said, "What's with the storm in New York City? The docks are absolutely clear." It's because the wind was blowing the snow into the river. So I thought, I'm going to go down and take one of my drop cams that I use at the studio and put it in the back window. And then I can see what the snow is doing fore and aft. So I did that, and that worked well. Except,
how cold of a trip was that?
It's only 5 blocks.
Okay.
It's five blocks. But it was a gym workout. Walking in 2.5 foot snow.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
With big high boots on. It is a workout. It is a workout. But, that's exactly right. Exactly right. And so I put a camera fore and aft, and with like every hour I would chat. Actually, I left it on one monitor, except I went out to get some dinner and I came back and it shot my boat on its side. And I thought, dear God. And
oh, no.
I know. And I can only watch one camera at a time. So I quick jumped to the other camera thinking, hopefully it's just the mount, the wind hit the boat. And so I jumped onto the other camera and indeed the bow shot, the boat was normal. And so it turned out that the camera, which was taped in the window, the tape started to let go.
Oh God.
And it showed the boat slowly turning over until it got down to the floor. And it's so.
Man, you know, here we got a whole 50% precipitation, I think. I don't, you know.
Well, precipitation in California is a bad thing because traffic gets berserk, right?
Oh, yeah, no. And I mean just water precipitation in the air. I don't even think it accumulated into any drops or anything. Yeah. I think it was a tiny bit humid, I think.
Okay.
How does the weather work like that? Where here, it's amazing weather all the time. I don't understand how there's a vortex of great weather here in L.A.
Well, I always felt that when I went to the Miami Boat Show, because the Miami Boat Show is in February, and it would be dreadful here. And then 2.5 hours later, it's 80. And I go, wait a minute, why is it? How come that warm weather doesn't roll up the coast a little?
Yeah. We had to shovel sand off of our beach because it was too nice. Yeah, it was real bad. Wow. We've had some, not to rub it in, but whether I haven't noticed anything.
Well, it's better now. It was 45 today, and so a lot of the snow just melted, which was great.
Yeah. Now, do you still find snow romantic? When it comes down, you feel
Dennis and I said, let's go to the park. I mean, the park is beautiful. When all the branches have snow on it, it's just amazing.
Yeah.
And then today I went down and all the snow is black from tire tracks and soot.
It's all now become ice and has like all this tarnished and crummy stuff.
Yeah, it fades fast. But those first couple of hours, they are beautiful.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh, and Malmesworth had thunder snow.
What is that?
Where it thundered, like it's like a thunderstorm during the snowstorm.
Oh God!
It's very weird.
That is weird.
Yeah.
That is weird. Yeah, that's crazy. That's crazy. Well, I guess let's jump into the show.
I'm doing two final CES things in categories. So this week it's CES things for babies, tots, kids, and next week CES gadgets for pets. So we're going to start with something from Four Moms. Now, I think it was last year, the year before, when Four Moms had a baby, baby rocker, an automatic baby rocker. So if your child fell asleep.
That thing that did the weird, undulating, it looked like a boat.
You could set it for like rocking, you could set it for rolling, you could set it for double
hiking.
Dips.
I mean, it was
hiking, roller coaster was amazing.
Yeah.
I rode that several times.
Yeah, it was quite exciting.
Okay, so now Four Moms has the self installing robotic car seat. It's really quite interesting, and here's the video.
So 4 out of 5 car seats are installed incorrectly. And that means there are 24 million kids riding around in cars today in car seats that are not installed right. So we've built a robot into the base of this car seat that installs on its own. So every single time you install the car seat, it's installed correctly. And when you click the carrier in place, it verifies the installation and turns on our continuous monitoring system.
And then how do I know that it did get locked in place?
Well, so there's a display on the side that walks through that process, and it communicates out to an app, and you can see it reported right in a dashboard. So here we verified that the latch anchors are in place, and we suggest where in the vehicle to install it. And then it shows us how to actually connect these latch anchors into the vehicle. Once those are connected, we'll push a button on the base, and the first thing it'll do is verify that the latch anchors are connected correctly. So it's doing that, it's confirmed that the latch anchors are connected. The next thing it does is ask us to level and tension the base. So we just push one button, and it'll go through the process of leveling itself and tensioning itself.
Okay, Now this is very complicated. So what is this retail for?
So the retail price is $499. Huh. It's going to be available this May at Amazon, Bye Bye Baby, specialty retailers.
Right. Now, I saw you had a carrier before. Is that part of it?
That is, yeah, the carrier is an integral part of the system as well.
You want to show us that?
Yep, so it's the base. It just finished tensioning, so now it's going to ask us to attach the carrier.
Oh, okay.
So we take the carrier, once it asks for it, there we go. We lock the carrier.
That's a nice looking device.
Yo, thanks very much. Once we click that in place, now it's going to verify the entire installation, the latches, the level, the tension, the connection between the carrier and the base,
the
battery level. It tells us that everything's verified and the car seat's safe to use.
It looked like it, didn't it?
Yeah.
And it enables that continuous monitoring, where now we can actually see in the app that on an ongoing and continual basis, it's checking and monitoring all of those systems and making sure that your car seat's safe to use.
Yep, baby's still in there. I saw a little baby icon. Wow! It's like... it feels like Iron Man for babies. You have the whole robotic system that... ratchets in.
Well, not only that, but according to Four Moms, most premium car seats ask you when you first set it up that you should make sure your car is parked on a level street. Okay. And so this automatically levels the seat out for you, so it doesn't matter. I mean, it's really pretty techie. Also, the app has a VIN capture, you know, for your car, and then it knows the make and the model, and then it tailors the instructions for you to the actual car you're putting it in. And you know what? I'm just looking at that. Hold on a second. They didn't mention this, but I just see it says pre-orders in January will get $100 discount.
Wow.
So if you happen to be, you only got 4 days left. So if you happen to be listening or watching this before January 31st, I assume midnight in California, and this does appeal to you, you can pre-order one for $100 less.
That is the Rolls Royce of cars, of children's seating.
Yes, not only that, it's been so long since I saw someone put a baby in a car seat. When he took out that whole thing with the convertible top and everything, that the carrier, I'm thinking, this is like a piece of machinery itself. I always think of a car seat as a little plastic thing with like its own little seatbelt that you throw the kid in and when you get to the end of the ride, look back and say, oh, he's still in it.
Yeah.
So, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
this has a five-point harness system. Look at that. Five-point harness system. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
And then a side impact something system. It's very, very.
Side
there you go.
Protection.
Side impact protection.
Oh, my gosh. Wow. Yeah. For the cost of an iPad, you too could have a baby carrier.
Yes.
You know,
you can have a baby grow up, and then you'll have to buy them the iPad.
Exactly. I also don't know what a normal cost for a car seat would be. This seems expensive, but I don't know.
Antastic is saying I've seen more expensive ones.
What? Okay.
Yeah, someone said, now if they steal your car, you say, oh, my God, they stole my car and my high-tech baby.
Yeah, so bring that back, that seat. Oh, my gosh. So I just went to Amazon, typed in car seat.
Oh, that's good.
Here's one.
Whoa.
$430, $275, $230. This is probably the one that I would buy, the $57 one,
right.
Or the $30 one.
Oh, yeah, you were going to buy the $37 one. It's Cross Your Finger Baby seat.
Yes. It's called Cross
Your Fingers
Band-Aid.
And hope for the best.
The Band-Aid car seat. Right. Yeah. So, wow. Car seats are expensive.
I know. But it's also funny. A lot of people in the chat room are saying, how did we ever survive to the age we are today? Because car seats, like I said, in those early days, it was a
they were made plastic out of cigarettes. I mean, I
yes,
don't
right. Mine had a drink holder for a highball.
It was, exactly. You know? It came with a mini bar.
Oh, the mini bar option was great.
I agree. How on earth did any of us make it past the age of 10?
But anyway, if you're a techie and you want the ultimate in car seats, check out the Four Moms website.
It seems like if you own a Tesla, you should own this car seat. And you have a child, you should own this car seat.
Yes. Well, they'll give you a child if you buy this.
Yeah, if you buy the seat, child comes free. Yeah. Well, that is I like it.
I thought it was. They certainly put a lot of effort into it, mm-hmm. and it's not one of those things where, you know, it had a lot of chrome and LEDs and nothing for the kid. It looks like they really put in a lot of safety features. And also at the beginning of the video, in case it didn't register, the guy said 4 out of 5 car seats are improperly installed.
Yikes.
That's only like 80% of all kids are riding around not buckled in properly. So this will tell you. Wow. Also, you know, it would be funny if the app, as cars go by, the app says, unsafe, unsafe car, unsafe baby, unsafe baby.
It guilts the rest of the drivers on the road.
Exactly.
So to let them know that they...
So you feel good about spending the money.
Yeah.
Okay, second baby gadget is also very interesting. It's called Temp Track. It is the Bluetooth wearable baby thermometer. And I thought the easiest way to describe it is they have a little minute and a half video on their website, and it'll tell you about Temp Track. With the appropriate
having a sick child is a difficult experience for any parent, especially when it comes to taking their temperature. You don't want to disturb your child, who is already feeling physical pain and discomfort, but you also want to know if he or she is getting better or worse. Enter TempTrack, the first 24-hour temperature monitor in the form of a soft, comfortable, single-use patch. Simply apply the patch under the arm like a Band-Aid, and TempTrack uses Bluetooth technology to send immediate readings to any nearby smartphone, yours, grandma's, or the babysitter's. TempTrack's built-in logging system continuously records and stores your child's temperature history, allowing you to share the readings with your doctor at the push of a button. While traditional thermometers are generally accurate, they require parents to continuously disturb a child that is not feeling well and are subject to user error. This adds to parents' emotional anxiety and worry for their child's well-being. Dr. Aris Iliadis agrees, saying, a 24-hour temperature monitor that continuously records a child's temperature readings could alleviate many of the concerns of parents caring for a sick child. The child can rest, and the parent can be alerted if anything changes. The makers of TempTrack designed the safe, comfortable patch with parents and young children in mind. Paired with our free Android or iOS-compatible smartphone app, TempTrack provides at-a-glance current temperature display, 24-hour wireless monitoring without disturbing your sick child, temperature alerts that tell you when a fever spikes, easy data sharing to keep your doctor and family members informed, and notes to indicate when your child eats, drinks, or takes medicine. Once the patch is applied, your child won't even notice it is on, so he or she can sleep and move comfortably throughout the day. TempTrack even tells you when it's time to replace the patch. TempTrack takes the guesswork out of monitoring your child's temperature and replaces it with complete accuracy and peace of mind, all day and all night.
Wow. Someone said in Twitch chat, coming to a theater near you, because it looks so sci-fi. That does not look real. Wow.
Yeah. Well, now the thing is, you know, if it's your kid, you're probably not going to be concerned about the money. Basically, you're paying a buck an hour to monitor the kids' temperature because it's $25, and it runs for 24 hours. It would be nice, but I doubt if you could do this. It'd be nice if, like, you could shut it off and then turn it back on again. But my guess is once you get it going, it just goes for 24 hours, and then you'll get a notification when the battery's dead. Well, I guess it has to send you a notification just before the battery dies. But I think a person who could get a good night's sleep knowing that their phone will go off for whatever temperature they set gives them it's probably worth the money. And also the fact that you have a record of the entire night of what the temperature was doing. And, you know, a lot of these apps say, and you can send it to your doctor. I can't imagine any doctor wanting to have their patients sending them wads of info about, you know, what's the kid's temperature now? I don't want to know what it was at 7 a.m.
I'm surprised. And you can buy it now. Which is,
yes,
I thought this was just a concept or like a Kickstarter video. It's available now.
It's available now. Exactly. I know it did get a lot of very good press. And like I said, I think it's a great idea if you're worried about, you'd like to get some sleep, but you don't want to get up every 3 hours. You certainly don't want to wake your baby who just fell asleep. So this is a real way to get rest and know you're going to be woken if the temperature goes over whatever you set it for.
Yeah. Wow. This is really cool. And I could have definitely seen when I had a flu as a teenager, how much I would have preferred, instead of sticking the thermometer under your tongue and dealing with a new, like, you know, cover every single time, stick something under my arm and keep it there, and then look at the phone and see if you're running a temperature at that moment.
Yeah, it's interesting. I have no idea up to you know, if there's an age cutoff.
Yeah, me neither. I was kind of wondering that. Sure that once if you start to grow hair in your armpit, that'd probably be a bad
too
spot.
Old. Too old.
You're too old.
Probably there's a warning right on it. If you lift a person's arm and there's hair there. Get a regular thermometer.
Yeah. Yeah, that was kind of gross. Probably TMI, but I bet that's the cutoff age.
Yeah.
Wow. We live in the future.
I think it's great. I think it's great, yeah. So that's TempTrack with a Q. TempTrack. And our final gadget is for slightly older kids. It's called Hack a Ball. And here's a little video about what that is.
Hey, Dick the Giz Wiz. They're hacking everything these days. Bank accounts. They're even hacking somebody's ball. And that's why we're here at Hack a Ball. And we're going to talk to Sebastian. Sebastian, what is Hack a Ball?
Well, Hack a Ball is a children's toy. It's a programmable rubber ball that's designed to teach kids the basics of programming through really simple play. So at its heart, it has some lights, sounds, and a vibration motor, and it reacts to motion. So you can throw it, you can drop it, you can bounce it around. And using a really simple app, kids can program the ball to do pretty much anything that they want in response to moving it around.
You know, I was watching a video before, and it seemed like there is one game where they have to gently hand each other the ball, and if you make the ball go red, am I getting this all confused?
Yeah, so the kids came up with a game called Don't Wake It, and they pretended the ball was a baby dragon's egg. And the idea is that if they pass it around really gently towards each other, they don't wake the dragon up. But if I pass it to you and I drop it a little bit, it should vibrate and you'll feel that they've woken the baby dragon up.
Oh, okay. So it would be off as you're passing it around. But if you really rough it up, it'll turn on.
Here we go. So hopefully. So it starts blue like that. And then if you pass it around, it stays blue. And then if you pass it to me.
You're a klutz. He's a klutz.
And I woke it up then.
Oh, you woke it up. Okay, and is this on sale now?
We've just sold out of our first batch of pre-orders, so we're going to be opening up new pre-orders in the next couple of weeks, and we'll be shipping those in June.
And what does it sell for?
It sells for $85 in the U.S.
Okay. So is it only on your website?
It's on our website at the moment. We're hoping that we'll be on Amazon shortly, and then for the end of the year, we really want to be in retailers. We've got a lot of retailers who are interested in us for Christmas.
Very interesting. And it's available online already.
It is?
Well, it says pre-order, I guess.
Yeah,
I guess
what they did, it was a Kickstarter, and they let me just find the amount here. They wanted $100,000. They got almost $250,000. They got $240,000. They got 3,000 people who ordered them. And they're building those 3,000 now, and they'll be shipped in March. And then they're building another 5,000, and that's what the pre-order will be for the next 5,000. Actually, there's a lot of engineering in there. Inside there, there's a gyro, accelerometer, vibration motor, 9 LEDs, rechargeable batteries, some memory, a speaker, Bluetooth.
Wow.
And yeah, I know. So kids can make up their own games, but if you don't happen to know how to do that, it comes with several built-in games. And again, I had no idea who would want to pay $85, but the fact that they raised $240,000 and sold 3,000 pretty quick, I guess some people do.
Yeah.
What's your take on this? You think it's fine expensive?
Yeah, I think its price is a little bit expensive. That's what the chat room seems to be mirroring as well. Is gosh, who has so much money to spend on toys? It seems like it would be really great in a classroom environment because you'd be able to use it. You know, let's say you get even just one, you could. It seems like it's newness.
No, that's it. Yes,
kind of that's go away.
That's a perfect idea. Like in a kid's nursery, not nursery, I guess a little bit older, is to have two of them as a class project and maybe hack them and make up a game for half the class, and the other half of class has to do whatever the game tells them.
Yeah,
that would be a perfect way to make the cost of one of them.
Yeah.
Stretch out
and then move on to the next classroom, you know?
Yeah.
And that seems interesting. I'm glad that there were so many. It seems like every day there's something. Hey, this will teach the basics of programming. This will teach the basics of programming. This is how to teach the basics of programming. I don't think that's a bad thing that there are just so many. Options on letting kids understand the very basics of getting into computer science because it's so approachable by the time that you get into middle school or high school when you're going to be learning those and that might be not approachable, you'll have already covered all the basics. Yeah, I know what a loop is. Yeah, I know what a function is. Yeah. You know,
give me a hard. Really cool. Give me something hard.
Yeah. I know these things. Come on, let's learn some if statements. What are we talking about? Let's go. So, that's really neat. That's very very neat. The hackball.
Loke in the chat room said, "If you could teach it to roll up and down my back and give me a massage, I'd buy one."
Yeah, exactly. If it could be a mood ring, show off what mood I have.
It's very funny saying that. Years ago, I'm going to say it's maybe five or six CESs ago, there was the robotic massaging. It looked like a little car. And you laid down on the table, and they put this car on your back, and the little tires would roll forward and, like, supposedly massage your back a little. But it felt like someone tickling you. And I said to person. I think it was $100 or
whoa.
Or I know, and I said, you know, it's just like you could get the same effect if you bought a little toy car and ran it over your back. And I said, well, we're working on trying to make the massage a little deeper tissue. So
we'll have the 62-pound version coming out this spring. That will give you a deeper massage.
It said, no, it does that. Just have a friend stand on the car as it runs up and
exactly.
down.
Exactly. You know, that reminds me of Robot Wars, which is actually coming back to television. I don't remember if you remember Robot Wars.
Was that where people build robots and have to fight each other?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Arena.
I don't know why that massage toy reminded me of it, but, you know, I'm sure that would...
Robot Massage Wars.
Robot Massage Wars.
There you go. There you go.
I think it's great. I think it's I think we have a plan here.
Oh, win something for the Playboy Channel. The Playboy the Playboy Tech Channel.
Exactly. Okay, so I think it is time.
Yes, for... ladies and gentlemen, it is time for Chad.
No, you don't need it.
Crappy.
But you might want it at Chad's Crappy Corner.
Get it.
Now, as we know, January turned out to be Chad's not-so-crappy corner because our wonderful Patreons who actually keep the show on the air voted on the theme for January, and it turned out to be gifts that Chad got for Christmas. And so is this the final week of them?
This is the last one.
Oh, okay. So they've not been crappy.
No, they haven't.
But maybe tonight we'll find out.
So to round up all those Christmas gifts, I'm going to do some stocking stuffers that I got this year. So a few smaller gadgets. So first, I'll start off with dun 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 spiders. This is the Hairy Scary Jumping Spider. This is a little toy that I got in my stocking mostly for my cats. In fact, I wonder.
Oh.
What if we could?
You know, looking at that box, I think my parents had one of these as a kid. This is like
really?
That box is like a reproduction of when it probably first came out, right?
It may be.
Does it have a little ball that shoots air into the spider?
Yeah, this is what the spider looks like, and it has a little hand pump, and it also has a little hole on it as well. So you cover that little hole with your thumb, and then when you press the, puffer? I don't know what this is called.
Yeah, that's like, yeah, puffer's good.
The spider jumps. And
oh my God!
So if you set him down on something flat, he will jump across it, which could either be a practical joke, a prank, or possibly to
scare someone
cats.
To death.
Yeah, exactly.
What does your cat think of it?
They didn't like it so much. You know, they were definitely very, very, very curious. In fact, I put it up on Instagram of me playing with waffles. And let's just bring that up here. And here it is.
So
she was quite scared of it, and then I just threw it at her, and she got the heck.
Whoa.
She got right the heck out of there in slow-mo. So I enjoyed the Hairy Scary Jumping Spider. That's just playing on repeat over there. Not too expensive. Hairy Scary Jumping Spider we found online for $8. With Prime available. So you too can get the Hairy Scary Jumping Spider for not too expensive. By the way, if you want to see what's going on in the bottom, you have this little
it's
like a tongue almost.
Yes.
That's making this jump up. Whoop. And so that's what makes it jump, and is quite spooky and scary.
It actually is.
So that's the Hairy Scary Jumping Spider.
Okay.
There has been one other theme, throughout this month, and that is,
yes,
my family knows that I like to enjoy alcohol. So, It seems like there's been a lot of alcohol-themed
Oh, not
products.
Another alcohol.
I'm telling you.
What, does your father own a bar?
My father's 24 years sober, which is pretty funny. They gave me these, which are called Perfect Pours. And you may have seen these at bars. But they go on the top of bottles of alcohol, and they will pour perfect 1.5 ounce shots. So every single time, and it'll stop. So let me just show this one off right here.
Okay.
And I have a little shot glass right here, and you pour it out, and it stops, just like that.
Oh, wow.
I guess this one is just an ounce. Exactly one.
So let's fill that up.
There we go. No, I'm not gonna. Definitely not gonna take this now. But in fact, I actually meant to grab the funnel that
Is that water or is that alcohol?
This is actually alcohol. I was gonna use that funnel. Remember how I showed off the funnel about 2 months back? I was actually gonna bring out the funnel and funnel it back in, but I forgot that, so it's not here.
Okay.
So these are called Perfect Pours, and
when you wake up in the morning and the cats are staggering all over the place, you'll know that they
that I forgot to put it back.
Put it back in the bottle.
Exactly, and so they pour out exactly what they're meant to measure, and I believe these are an ounce measurement each. One thing that I've found is that for some bottles, the head of the bottle is too wide, and it doesn't inside of it, so it would just fall right out. Okay. So some bottles may work better than others, but those are the Perfect Pours, which are.
How many do you get? How many do you have?
They got me. You can buy these on Amazon in a pack. So I believe that they got me a dozen, which I have not used. I haven't used them.
A dozen.
But they're not. They're also not too expensive. So this dozen is $30, which I guess is actually a little more expensive than I remember. So $30 for Prime. So close to.
And they come with no alcohol.
Yeah, no alcohol. No alcohol included. And these are just 1 ounce. So finally, and I had opened up the door to my studio to hope that a cat would wander by. In fact, I'm wondering if we should pause and I go get one for.
Okay.
Yeah, let's pause real fast, and let me go grab a cat. So we're back, and this time I have a kitty friend with me. Just woke her up.
Wow.
So the very last stocking stuffer I got was a Star Wars gadget. So we're going to have to come here, Waffles. So this is a Princess Leia cat hat. You can see that it will add buns.
Okay.
Buns to the kitty. Now, it has on the top little holes that her ears are supposed to go through. But these, unfortunately, are very small. You can kind of see that I'm trying to put my finger all the way through there. And I don't think her wide ears are going to fit all the way through these. So we're just going to kind of lay this right on top.
Okay, so.
Okay.
Let's see how the cat model.
You're going to be okay, Waffles? Here.
Waffles, I would read my contract.
We didn't get her the full Slave Leia outfit, unfortunately, but...
oh, my gosh.
Help me,
Waffles.
Obi-Wan Kenobi. You're my only hope.
Oh, that is a riot.
And she couldn't look any more thrilled, right? So this may be the large version. Here, we're going to set you down, poor kitty cat. Don't run too far. Okay, now that you're laying
Waffles
down.
Waffles is very good.
She's a very docile kitty.
Normally, you would think she would be in the other room or your face where you would be on your way to a hospital.
Yeah. I think she looks great. Oh, it
Waffles,
fell off just
it's
a bit.
You. Oh.
This is the spring. I feel like she's a really good model, modeling
yes.
the spring collection here. We're just going to put this down around your chin. Sorry, poor kitty.
Waffles, you really are amazingly docile. Look at that. How much alcohol did you give that cat before the show?
This bottle was full, let me tell you. Isn't she the best? Okay, it keeps falling off. I'm so sorry. I don't know.
I guess the ear holes are really necessary so that the ears hold it in place.
She's starting to realize that she probably doesn't like this so much.
One more look at your waffles. Let's see.
Okay, waffles. Give a good old look. Here, I'm trying to get her whiskers out because I know that's bothering her. Okay, one more good look at the camera.
Let me see, waffles. Oh, my God, it's Princess Leia.
Princess Leia. Help me, Dickie D. You're my only hope. Get me out of here.
Saying.
Get me out of here,
Why
Dickie
did
D.
I ever want to come into this room?
Jeez, goes. Okay, I'm learning by association. This is not the best room to be in. Your buns are looking good, Waffles. I like them.
Okay. And what does that cost?
So this, the Star Wars Princess Leia cat hat, this is just a measly $12 with Amazon Prime.
Okay. Is there anything that Star Wars merchandisers have missed out on?
If you say it aloud, they'll be notified, and then they will market that as well.
Oh,
so
God. That is so funny.
That is, isn't that ridiculous? So thank you so much to my parents and family and cousins and everyone for all the gifts and all the great gadgets that we showed off this month. Thank you so much. And with that, let's move on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
We'll see how
someone in the chat room is saying that you owe that cat a can of tuna.
I owe her a commission for this episode. I think the Screenwriters Guild is going to get all over me if I
exactly.
If I don't get her. Oh,
you know, this is apropos of all these drink things. Dick, you've probably been inundated with videos about the soft drink keeper you wished was available last week when Chad was showing off the wine preserver. You can see my video I made about Fizz Keeper by Joe Carey. Cheers, Ian. So here's Ian's video of the week.
Hi, Dick and Chad. This is Ian from Sydney, Australia, or a little bit south of Sydney, Australia. We're currently having up to 28 degrees Celsius days. Lovely summer.
Which is hot.
Chad showed off a couple of devices for saving wine or preserving wine for a few days once the bottle's open. One was for extracting the air from it. My device is a little bit different. This goes over the top of the bottle and you put the pump on in a similar way. Works just as well as the one Chad showed. The other one he had was for sparkling wine. Put that on the bottle.
This that's the exact
version,
one.
As you can see.
Yeah, that
There's
is.
Also a
yeah,
plastic
the champagne
version,
one,
which works in a similar way. You put that into the top of the bottle and bring the clip around. But Dick, you said you wish there was something for ordinary fizzy drinks. And there is. There is. There's this device. You screw that, you remove the lid, you screw this in onto the bottle, and pump away. It repressurizes the bottle so it saves the gas in the drink.
Maybe like a 2 liter bottle? Or
probably about 20, 25 years old. I did a quick Google search. It's still available. It's called Fizz Keeper from Jacari. You can look up the jacari.com website or Google or do a search on Amazon for Fizz Keeper and you'll find it today's the 27th and it was $11.50 for a pack of three. So that's that's your answer, Dick.
That is great.
That is good.
He's right. Jacari Fizz Keeper, Pump and Pour. And it's for a bottle of soda. And it's here on Amazon as an add-on item for $4.95. There's all sorts of other ones.
Yeah. Oh, you know, there seem to be a lot of them. Oh, yeah. There's the actual one he showed.
Yeah.
That's the pumpy one. And how much is that? Because I said it, I think he said it's a three-pack,
yeah,
right?
Three-pack for $11.78.
Oh, and regular Prime.
Yeah.
Oh, no, it's an add-on, right?
Yeah. No, this one's regular Prime. This one is.
Oh.
One day. Oh, no, free one-day shipping.
Oh, yeah, but it's delivered tomorrow if it orders over $35.
Oh, got it.
But
yeah,
but 2 days is good. That's good.
Yeah. Wow.
I'm going to get some.
That's great. And it looks like, you know, just in related results, this looks like it might clamp over a can. And do the same thing, Fizz Keeper, for cans. I can't
tell. What? Is that a little bellows on the top?
Yeah, it looks like it clamps on to the top of the can. You pull over, and it clips, and then you use this little pump on the top to push it.
Oh my word!
Interesting.
That is very
interesting.
We
found it.
Wow. He did. So, Ian, you live in Australia. We don't send mads outside of U.S. or Canada. But, Ian, you should buy stock in Fizz Keeper because I'm buying them, and I'm sure many others will. So thank you for – it's very funny. I think my mother had something like that when I was a kid. And the fact that he said his is 25 years old – it's kind of interesting that when you find a gadget that has that kind of longevity, so it must work.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
What kind of reviews did it get, Chad?
He seems like he's a connoisseur of things that haven't, you know, keeping your... He had the wine one, he had the champagne one, and now he has the Fizz Keeper one. He seems like he really
He knows where they all are. Did you notice the cabinets behind him?
I know.
All of the cups lined up neatly.
Yeah.
Amazing.
So it was $13.48 for the three-pack.
For a three-pack of those. Oh, and that they got pretty good reviews.
Yeah, yeah. And the reviews are good. And then going back to the other four stars. And then
out of how many people?
Out of, this one has 58, but the one just before it was 550.
Wow. That's a pretty good sampling.
That is a great sampling. Very good.
Excellent. Excellent. Ian, again, thank you. And cheers back to you from Chad and I.
And if they have any more videos... Where should they send them?
Yes. Well, we know one person who's going to put a video back on the air, Dave. Okay. I said, Chad, I got a great video. Look at this. And Chad went there and said, there is no video there. It's been removed. So we're working on Dave to put the video back. But we're waiting for you to send us a video. And it can be things about that we talked about, like Ian there finding something that we said we wish existed. So send us a video. My favorite gadget is one. My gadget warehouse, that's our favorite, where you find something old. Make a 2 to 3 minute video, put it on YouTube, and you can make it unlisted so that other people won't stumble across it. Send the link to... mail@gizwiz.tv. And if you live in the U.S. or Canada, you'll get the current issue of Mad and one of those now 37-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures. So we have one for next week if Dave puts the link back up, but we'll need more soon. So send us your viewer video for the show.
That is great. And with that... it is time to move on to the letter.
La 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 letters. La 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 letters.
Okay, letter is hi, Dick and Chad. I was home for the holidays, and since my mother is a bit of a hoarder, I just knew I would find this gem in my bedroom closet. Sure enough, right where I left it, I found it. My Mad Magazine board game. Since I'm Canadian, my edition of the board game is in English and in French. I've attached some pictures of the game, including the rules, showing that the winner is the first person to lose their money, along with the $1 million plus bill. I can't wait to play it soon again. I love the show and I love the chat rooms. Keep up the awesome work. Anne, who is fantastic in our chat room. So as you can see, can we run back?
Yeah, let me grab those 1 second.
So Parker Brothers came to Mad and said, we want to do a Mad Magazine game. And Bill, the publisher and founder of Mad, said, we don't want you to take an old game and say now it's the Mad game. If we do anything with a game, it has to be Mad-like. And so they came up themselves with a satire on Monopoly. And so the object here is the person who wins is the first person who can go bankrupt. And as you see, one stack of cards is the English card, and the second stack of cards on Anne's version is cart, C-A-R-T-E. Since it's French and English. And then the object and the object of the game, and it says on the instructions, the object is the first person to lose, repeat, lose all of your money.
Oh, my gosh. That is great.
And the game did very well. And there's the playing board.
Wow,
for
here, I'm trying to zoom in just a bit
Whoops,
I marked all over this image.
The funny thing about playing it is that you're so used to playing Monopoly that you'll pick up a card and it'll say you inherit $50,000, and your first instinct is to say, "Oh boy!" And
hooray!
Then right, but then after a while you go, "Oh no, not more money."
So, that's great. I love this this bill. This $1,329,063. Dollar bill.
Yeah, I know. It's very. It was a very funny game, and it was great because they said to Bill, "We want to do a media tour." Back then, there was no internet, and say we want to send someone from city to city to city promoting the game, and Bill said, "I have the person for you," and so I went on
that's
a tour.
Cool. Wow.
Yeah, it was great fun. It was great fun.
That's amazing. That is very fun. That seems like something I would do too. It's like,
oh,
sign
you would
me
be
up.
Yes, you like, would be great.
Put me on a bus. I'd love to go talk to people about this game.
And that was a very, you know, I've done a couple of other tours, like for my own book, where you book your own transportation. You stay at the cheapest hotels because, you know, Mad's paying for it and they're cheap. Since Parker Brothers organized a tour, they sent me on tour with somebody who did all of the arrangements, set up all the cars, set up all the checking into hotels, all the checking out. And basically, all I would do is get a call. There's a car downstairs in 20 minutes. We're going to so and such and such station.
God,
so it was
nice.
Great. Yes. And there was one additional perk. Roy, I unfortunately forgot your last name. He worked for a PR agency. And then after many years, he went over and became the PR person for 60 Minutes. And we had emails, but I keep saying, Roy, you have to get 60 Minutes. You have to get Mad on 60 Minutes. And he said, you need a hook. It has to be, we can't just say, here's Mad. And finally, I think it was Mad's 35th anniversary. And I said, Roy, 35 years, no ads. Is that not a story? And he said, let me talk to them. And he called back and said, they're interested. So, and that was the point at which I went I said, wait a minute, I have to ask Bill Gaines. So I went in and I said, Bill, you want to be on 60 Minutes? And he said, is there a downside? And I said, if you've been embezzling, if you've been draining money from the company and putting it in your own personal account, I would turn this offer down. I said, but if mad is what it is.
And then
is,
he looks at you dead in the face and goes, let's not do it.
Yeah, let's not do it. Exactly. He said, trust me, I have nothing to hide. So we got on 60 Minutes.
That's what they all say.
Yeah. Yeah. Wait, when they get their reporters on it, they'll dig up something. Trust
That's
me.
Great. That's great. Wow. What a cool. And to also have the French version. That is
yes.
Such a cool little.
Yeah, it was great. It was great.
That's great.
Antastic, thank you. It was super.
Thank you, Antastic. Thank you for being such a valued member of our chat room, too. Thank you. And we have some more thanks to give out. Oh, my gosh. Thank you to everyone who supports on Patreon. The show's not over yet, but we do want to give a big thank you to the folks who support the show. You guys really do make this show possible. Thank you. Is it worth a dollar? Is it worth less than a latte a month for the show? How much does a latte cost now?
Oh, like $5.
Perfect. Yeah, exactly. See, less than a latte, you can get the Giz Wiz for an entire month. So thank you so much to everyone who supports the show. You guys really, really make the show float and live on. So thank you
and
so
we don't,
much.
And we don't plead, but we could use some more subscribers.
We're not getting a 60-minute spot anytime soon.
No, we're not. So if you are enjoying it and you could support us, it would be super.
It would be super. And thank you to everyone who does support who has been supporting. Thank you so much for supporting independent content creators like ourselves. Now, you should go and play What the Heck Is It?
Oh, really? Where is that?
Oh, my gosh. Gizwiz.biz is the place to go to play the game. Just scroll down on the side. You'll see What the Heck Is It? There he is, Dickie D. We're trying to figure out what it is. And this is what we have.
I have no idea what that
Dick
is.
Dick doesn't know. I don't know. How are we going to figure it out? We need you to write in. Let us know what this is. I think that this is obvious. I mean, it's pretty obvious. You're going to go to a picnic, and you need a way to transport your hot dogs. So you stick your hot dogs in this nice little carrying case. It has a nice handle on top. You can transport your hot dogs without worrying that they're going to fall in the dirt or fall in the sand. It is a very fantastic hot dog transportation system.
Wow, you know what? I'm gonna try and beat you and write that answer and win because that's got to be correct.
Oh my gosh. Before I write mine in, because there's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers and 24 for cute, silly, hilarious, or ridiculous answers. We like creativity on the show. So get a writing. If you want to catch this show live, we're live almost every Thursday, except for today, at gizwiz.tv. Remember gizwiz.biz? Gizwiz.tv. Very similar, just a different top-level domain. And there we are live streaming to you, and you can also join the chat room. You can, if you don't catch it live, don't worry. We have recorded the show for you. And
wow, that's new.
Yeah, we did this time. It's time that's we recorded.
I think that's a great idea. Yeah. That old thing of where when someone would click on the link and we had to do it live, I was getting really tired.
Yeah, yeah. Those midnight binge sessions that some of our fans would do is not
when you tune in at 3 a.m. and click on the link, did you ever notice that the show was just 3 minutes long?
Yeah, exactly.
That's because we were too tired.
Hey, Chad. Okay.
Baby seat, Chad.
Yeah, see ya. Yep.
This goes in a bottle.
There's a spider. Okay, moving on.
Okay, bye. I'll be here. Bye.
So now we've recorded it, and using the magic of technology, it will play back for you. And you can even subscribe on iTunes or YouTube. So check out all the links there on our site. And if you want to find that Patreon link one more time, it's right at the top. Go ahead and click right there. Or if you could donate one time via PayPal, we have that as well. So thank you so much. With that, I think that wraps it up for this episode of The Giz Wiz. We will see you next time.
I'll be here.